this war memorial to those who have returned and those that never will. It gives me the greatest of pleasure to ask a very dear friend and gentleman to unveil our memorial today. He is a gentleman known to many of us here today, as someone who always has the time of day to stop and reminisce on stories of the past and recollections of his experiences here on the airbase during the war years. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I would like to ask Walter Nottage, BEM, to step forward and unveil our new war memorial.
She worked on the base as an air ministry driver. Sadly,
She passed away some 7 years ago. But shortly before she died, she wrote a poem recalling her memories of the war years. My wife, Wendy, has kindly offered to say this poem here for you today. Wendy, would you like to step forward?
So far behind. From the airfield that was my place of occupation, I watched with interest the beginning of many operations. Ground crews loading planes with fuel, bombs and ammunition. The Merlin engines roaring with hostile intention. Trucks, soon now, there will be no mouths to tell. Just history books. And a few pictures as well, about the brave guys who fought like hell. Many passed on now, but remembered so well. What the war years for them had been, since they first saw this England green. God grant peace to those that are left, and to remember the 92nd Bomb Group as one of the best. And I'm very proud to have you, the home of fame's favoured few.
You have many memories. You have many thoughts. There are some of us here who have no memories and have no thoughts of those times. But together, we wish to remember. We want to pay our respects. Let us pray. Bless us this day as we remember with grateful hearts the men of the 92nd Bombardment Group. We thank thee, Lord, that for them all sorrow and pain is at an end. And we praise thy holy name for all fond memories of our dear departed friends. We offer this prayer today through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.